you want to make slideshow presentations instantly with AI? You, my friend, are in the right place. In this video, we are going to look at two of the most popular apps, and I'm going to give you a backstage pass to what it looks like to be part of live calls with me and some of my homies. All right, smash like, let's go. So I typed, this is what I did. I went in to the tool and I typed in, it said, what is the theme of your slideshow, launch a podcast. And so what it first did was it generated an outline, and then you can go in here and you can adjust your outline accordingly. Like if you want to add your own ideas, thoughts, stories, etc. Maybe you want to add, I didn't add anything. I just said, cool, go with it. Actually, that's not completely true. I added in like a couple different ways to monetize the show. And I said, hit create presentation. And it gave me, this is what it gave me. I didn't add any tools, any insights, anything. It did this all by itself. So crafting your podcast concept, set distribution, monetization, growth strategies, defining your niche. I did add this image in there because I was kind of playing with it. But it put together what I would say is a very clean looking finish. And, you know, so here's one of the cool things you can do. You can just say, hey, I don't like this image. Can you generate an AI image for me or suggest based on these words? Do something like this. You can insert your own images. I could upload an image here of like, something like this. Again, I'm waiting to get a response back from them so I can get like they can give me a discount or a paid plan for free or something like that. And I'll do something a little more comprehensive, but I was very impressed with how quickly it was able to put this together and how professional it looked.
That's great. Do you think platforms like this, let's say I've got a script, because right now I've got a script of my magic pill offer that I want to speak to, and I was just going to record a loom of me speaking to some slides. But if I were to upload that script into here, would it be able to spit out something a little bit more polished than what I have? Wondering.
Well,
maybe.
So maybe there's a marriage between ChatGPT and PopAI or Beautiful.ai. Like maybe you use ChatGPT to kind of refine the script, for example, or the outline. Or maybe here, let me see if there's a way that I can like delete this maybe. Delete this. Let me see if I can try this here. So, what's a topic? Or Candace, if you like, you could just send me, like email me a link to that description or something that you've put together, that script you have.
Okay, let me see.
And while you're pulling that up, I'm just going to kind of show you something else I thought was like super dope. ChatGPT told me I had to stop using ChatGPT for today. I was just going nuts with it. I was playing.
Oh, no.
It's like you're using it too much. So this is pretty cool. This is a GPT I was playing with, and it's called Cartoonize Yourself. And what it does is it turns you into a Pixar character. So I just uploaded an image of myself here. This is what it gave me. Takes 2 seconds. Nice. I uploaded an image of my son here. This is what it gave me. Like, how cool is that? This is kind of like a fun thing. This isn't like game breaking productivity stuff, but I thought it was super cool. For this, it gave me like, not exactly what I was looking for. So I said, try again. It gave me this. You know, so from picture of my wife to picture of my wife. Anyway, this is the type of stuff that it just delights me. Brings me joy to see stuff like this happen. Pretty cool.
Yeah, that's awesome. Did you say this integrates with Zapier?
This app? This GPT?
No. Sorry, the PopAI.
The PopAI?
Yeah.
I don't know that it integrates with Zapier. So just as another side note, my goal today was to kind of continue along the lines of the blog and the email automation. And I wanted to use Cast Magic because Cast Magic is more robust and it does integrate with Zapier, but it didn't have the functions that I needed. So what did I do? I reached out to the developer of the app. I have a meeting with him today at 1:45 and we're going to talk about how to integrate that. Because the problem that it has now, the problem that I have is I'm managing 10 different shows in Cast Magic. And it doesn't allow me to select the specific show that automates. It just automates whatever gets uploaded. So anyway, I have a meeting with him today. We should be able to get, hopefully get that Zap set up, which I think will be cool.
I can't find my edited one, but I threw together something really quick. I don't want to sidetrack the meeting. So let me drop it in the...
I'm going to use it to enhance my existing presentation. See how that goes.
You're testing it? Okay, I want to see what that looks like.
Yeah. Do you want me to do it real time with you?
Yeah.
Okay. And then this way you can see what the other one looked like. I'll show you that too. All right, let's see. So I just exported it to PowerPoint.
Cool. And that one that you have there was generated by Beautifully.ai? Is that the one?
Yeah. Yeah, where is it? So this was... I mean, and I've put a lot of work into it, but the majority of it was generated with AI. And can I show you kind of how I created this? Because I think that part's pretty cool too.
Sure.
So I have this spreadsheet that I plug in all the information about the event, including the sponsorship levels and all that. And then I create a ChatGPT prompt that plugs in all of the event details, including our goals and the sponsorship packages and all that. And then I just barely to put it into this other system, I plugged that prompt in. So this is what the prompt actually looked like. So it's, you know, a thorough prompt for AI sponsorship deck creation, right?
How did you get it from your spreadsheet to ChatGPT? Did you do like a copy and paste or did you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. You just copy this. That you can see it's still copied. I literally.
It's interesting that you're using the notations of cells, right? So I see like A3, for example, because that's where that particular piece of information, I guess, is included, right? Dashboard B3.
Yeah, yeah. I can't show you the dashboard because it actually has a lot of information I wouldn't be able to show you, but I can show you like the sponsorship packages. This shows like, you know, we broke down each different level, figured out the price for it, and then this AI prompt, which I also have for event descriptions, ticket ideas. So those kind of came from a prompt, right? And then it just plugs them all into this concatenated ChatGPT prompt, right?
That's cool.
I just adjusted it a little bit. I made sure it said AI presentation generator. And then that's what I plugged in here. Right. So it's a very thorough prompt. Right. And then it says, this is what it gave me. Right. So I haven't plugged this into the other one that you just said, but I do want to try that. I imagine I'll have to do a trial beforehand, but
I can actually do it here too. After you show, just copy and paste that like into chat or something. And I can run it through the generator too, to see what it looks like on my credits or whatever. What I love about this is you're able to create this comprehensive prompt very easily just using the data that's already in the spreadsheet.
Mm-hmm. Like
the data is already there. All you do is say, hey, take the data from this cell, from this cell, from this cell, put it together in prompt and then upload that into ChatGPT to give yourself almost like a mega prompt in a way.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, and that's exactly what it is. This is what I've been telling you that I've wanted to show you, because it's super cool. Like, and I had to, let's see, how did I do the sponsorships? Because that part was kind of tricky. I think I had to put it, I don't know. There's a formula that is, you list everything that is, you know, below it. And that was somewhere here. Going. So this grabs all of the text that is, you know, in cells, you know, A through D on the sponsors tab. This is a whole different thing on its own, but that's basically it. And then it creates this list from, you know, oops. Okay, the right thing. Creates a list that has all of the different details. I gotta put it, where did I put that? So this is what that created.
Yeah. Right?
So then what you gotta do, you create that list from, you know, the other cell, and then I just pull it in here. So it's a little cleaner.
Cha-ching.
And then you have, it's always good to have a cell for additional details that you can kind of guide it, you know, to finesse the ChatGPT prompt, right? So you might say, I'm using whatever this other one was called, PopAI, right? That's pretty much it. And then, you know, it didn't create all of this, but this is kind of essentially what it did create. The ones that it did without much editing was, you know, this one, big whoop. These two, if I had to add some text, but if I had it, it would have done it. You know, this was kind of cool. I thought this little timeline was nice.
Yeah, it's really cool. Did it build out the colors too? Did you, or you told it the colors that you wanted in the prompt?
Yeah, so it did pull a lot of the colors and the logos from the website, because I had, you know, our websites in the prompt as well. So
Because I really, you know, it's a good contrast, the colors that we're using here.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's what's nice about this too, is you can choose a theme and customize it based on the theme. So these colors are, you know, default, and it chose those from the branding of his event and or his company and my company. So yeah. I mean, that's pretty much what it looks like. So I'm curious if you guys want, we can see how it tells us to improve it.
Yeah.
Might as well.
I'm curious, because I find typically, like, I used it, one of the GPTs that I was playing with today is like a humanize it. It says, we turn AI generated text into text that is looks like it's written as a human. And it didn't change it hardly at all. So I'm curious as to what this is gonna look like. It just, the text would just, it looked very similar.
Yeah, okay. Cool. Image source. I don't know about that. What do you think we should do? AI search? AI generation?
Generation.
Yeah. Ah! What do we need? Oh, it says pro right next to it. All right, we're just going free. What can we do for free?
I'm very likely, once they give me some sort of discount or sponsorship or whatever, I'm going to pay for it to kind of like dive deeper, because I think it's super cool. They have a pretty solid affiliate program too, this app. Which, by the way, Dan, I've been doing a lot of thinking based on our talk and whatnot. And like, I feel like going the direction of being like, you know, an AI tech solutions, almost like company. Makes a lot of sense. YouTube, mastermind, newsletter. A lot of the stuff that we end up recommending is going to be, there's going to be affiliate links and stuff. It's
yeah. Yeah. Yes. Love it.
So
I think that's great. Cause like, this is so much fun, right?
It is.
You set up a bunch of affiliate links. We jam on some tools and figure out how to utilize them better together. Right. I mean, I hope that, and I'm making this spreadsheet that I've got a template, and yeah, hopefully that helps. It's just concatenating formulas or, you know, text in a spreadsheet, and it's not bad. So I don't know, part of me doesn't want to edit anything and just see what happens.
Yeah. Let it ride.
Just go.
And so, and all the information that is in that outline came from the spreadsheet prompt that you created?
No, this came from, I uploaded my presentation.
Well, so right, but that was designed by the spreadsheet prompt.
Yeah, there was definitely a lot of work that went into it.
That's fair.
But yeah, for the most part, you know, like you, custom images and some text revision.
you know your spreadsheet better than we do. I'm interested to hear what you think about the slides.
This is very similar to what it gave you.
It looks very similar. Now there's different themes, probably have to pay for the different themes.
Yeah. Here's where your presentation begins.
Also worth noting, you can export in a presentation file and then like upload to like Google Slides or PowerPoint or something where it could be more easily edited.
Mm-hmm.
You need to have like a higher tier subscription for that, but interesting.
Sorry for the noise. Yeah, I mean, this is okay. This is like the same thing it gave you, right?
Yeah.
I wonder how much different, the themes are just different colors, it looks like.
It looks very, it doesn't look as nice as the one that you had put together, but that's probably because you had put some extra work into it with branding and whatnot.
Yeah, for sure. Will it let me do another one using the prompt? Do you want me to try that?
No, because you've already used one. Let me do it.
Oh yeah, cool.
You know, so what that looks like to me, because like in PowerPoint or in Google Sheets or Google Slides, for example, you get a template which looks like this, but then you have to manually go in and input all of the data, all the words, right? This kind of skips that whole step of inputting. It automatically inputs them all into the slides for you. So I'm glad you like this video. I'm glad you like this session. I'm excited for you to go out and create your own amazing slideshows with AI. By the way, leave a comment below, because one of the best ways for me to create content that helps you save time with AI is for you to leave your comments and questions below so I can go out and find the solutions for you. All right. Thanks for doing that. Also, as a side note, it helps me reach 100 extra people. For every comment, we reach 100 new people. Pretty dope, right? Cool. All right. Thanks for watching. Thanks for leaving a comment. Thanks for liking. All that good stuff. I'll catch you in the next video, right? Peace.